Welcome to MCOM second semester research methodology subject lesson number 21. Today's topic is the comparative scales as a part of the other scaling techniques in the scale and scale construction techniques or as a part of the research methodology unit 20. I am Dr. K. V. Somnath, J.S. College of Commerce, Vardha, your teacher for research methodology. Dear students, till the last lesson, we have learned about what is scaling, what is measurement, what is the importance of measurement and techniques and scales, various types of scales and some primary scales we have covered. Today, in this lesson, we will go for learning of some other category scales, like other scaling techniques. We will be going for learning in this. So, the other scaling techniques, as you have been observing in this slide, they can be classified under two categories, comparative scales and non-comparative scales. So the comparative scales can be further divided into four categories: paired comparison, rank order, constant sum, and Q-sort scaling. On the other hand, the non-comparative scales can be classified into two heads: continuous rating scales and itemized rating scales. The itemized rating scales will be categorized under Likert scale, semantic differential scale, and Staple scale. Anyhow, in this particular lesson, we will be going to learn about the comparative scales as a part of the other scaling techniques, which comprises the paired comparison, the rank order, the constant sum, and the Q-sort scaling. Let us first go for what is a comparative scale learning. For comparing two or more variables, a comparative scale is used by the respondents. Following are some different types of comparative scaling techniques. Number one is the paired comparison. A paired comparison symbolizes two variables from which the respondent needs to select one. This technique is mainly used at the time of product testing to facilitate the consumers with a comparative analysis of the two or major products in the market. To compare more than two objects, say comparing P, Q and R, one can first compare P with Q and then the superior one, which is with the R. For example, a market survey was conducted to find out consumer preferences for the network service provider brands A and B. The outcome of the service was as follows: brand A 57%, brand B 43%. So thus it is visible that consumers prefer brand A over brand B. This is what we call as paired comparison. Paired means where there are two variables or two brands or one set where there will be two objects, right? Next we will go for rank order. In the rank order scaling, the respondents need to rank or arrange the given objects according to his or her preferences. I will give an example here. There is a soap manufacturing company which is conducting a rank order scaling to find out the orderly preference of the consumers. It asked the respondents to rank the following brands in the sequence of their choice. So there are some four brands, namely brand 4, brand 5, brand X, brand V, brand X, brand Y and brand Z. And the ranks as given by the respondents, the brand V got 4th rank, the brand X got 2nd rank, the brand Y got 1st rank, and the brand Z got 3rd rank. So if you observe the table, the scaling shows that Soap Y is the most preferred band, followed by soap X, and the least preferred one is the soap V. So it is a rank ordering. We have already studied in our degree the Spearman's rank correlation. Right? You might have remembered well how the Spearman's rank correlation is conducted. So in that there will be an order placing either what you can say rank 1, 2, 3, adjusting the variables in the ascending order or the descending order and ranking them, and according to that the correlation is being conducted. So here also in the rank order scaling, the respondents needs to rank or arrange the given objects arranging to their required preferences. Right? So this is one type of scaling. Next one is constant sum scaling. It is a scaling technique where a continual sum of units like dollars, points, chips, etc. is given to the features, attributes and importance of a particular product or service by the respondents. In research also, most of the times we use this constant sum. For example, the respondents belonging to three different segments were asked to allocate 50 points to the following attributes of a cosmetic product P. So what are the attributes? How the particular product is finished, whether the particular product is skin friendly or not, whether the product is having fragrance or not, whether the packaging is effective or not, or attractive or not, whether the price is reasonable or not. So here we are going to find out whether how the people have segmented it or preferred it. So there are segment 1, segment 2, segment 3. Like that there are three types of segments. And for every attribute, the respondents have given some their preferences. Say in the segment 1, the finishing has been given 11 people preferred. In segment 2, finish has been preferred by 8 people. In the segment 3, finishing has been preferred by 9 people. Regarding the soap, in the segment 1, 11 people opined skin friendly, 12 people opined skin friendly, and in the segment 3, 12 people again opined skin friendly. In the case of the fragrance, in the segment 1, 7 people, in the segment 2, 11 people, in the segment 3, 8 people have preferred. As far as the packaging of a soap is concerned, in the segment 1, 9 people, in the segment 2, 8 people, in the segment 3, 10 people. And the price consideration is concerned, in the segment 1, 12 people, in the segment 2, 11 people, in the segment 3, again 11 people have preferred or shown their preferences. Out of the total 50 points, they have to be. So from the table, the constant scaling analysis, we can see that segment 1 consider product P due to its competitive price as a major factor. And the segment 2 and the segment 3, it refers to the product because it is skin friendly. So if you observe that, the points have been preferred or put under the constant sum method. So it is a scaling technique where a continuation or what you can say a sum of the units of the preferences about the attributes of a particular product will be taken into consideration. The same is also being applied in the case of measuring the data, because in a questionnaire if we have asked such a question and the people have been given to point out their preferences in the case of product 1 or case 1, case 2, case 3 or reason 1, reason 2, reason 3. So like that, where there is a need of using the constant sum scale which have a overall cumulative effect over the data collected. The next one is Q-SOT scaling. The Q-SOT scaling is a technique used for sorting the most appropriate objects out of a large number of given variables. It emphasizes on the grouping of the given objects in a descending order to form similar piles based on specific attributes. It is suitable in the case where the number of objects is not less than 60 and more than 140. The most appropriate of all ranging between 60 to 90. If you observe this, the Q-sort scaling, there is an obligation on the part of the respondent to go for responding in a three manner: low efficiency, moderate efficiency, high efficiency, like that the example shows. In the similar manner, the people are supposed to go for selecting an appropriate objective out of the large number of given variables, and after that, basing upon the preferences, the scaling will be done. That how many people or respondents are offering or perceiving low efficiency, how many are perceiving moderate efficiency, and how many are perceiving high efficiency. So Q-sort, that's why it is called as Q-sort. How many people are in queue for a particular feature or a particular attribute or for a particular response, whether it is low, whether it is moderate, or whether it is high efficiency. I hope you might have gone through all the things. Let us go once again. In this lesson, you have learned about the comparative scales as a part of other scaling techniques. And the other scaling techniques have been divided into two categories, comparative scales and non-comparative scales. And in this lesson, we have learned about the comparative scales. Under the comparative scales, we learned about pair comparison, rank order, constant sum, and Q-sort scaling. And under the comparative scales, we learned about pair comparison, where two objects have been compared. If it is more than two, we will go for one by one, comparing two objects only. For example, there are P, Q, R, S. Then how will we do? We will go for a comparison of P and Q. Which one comes out of the P and Q? For example, Q has come in. And then after Q and R will be compared. And out of the Q and R, which one knows, for example, R has come. And then R and S will be compared. And finally, R may emerge into a superior. So like that, there will be paired comparison. Means you will be going for observing the variables in a paired manner. Next one is ranking order. Now the people are asked to provide the responses in a ranking manner. And the better the ranker to a given particular reason or a product in the case of marketing or in the case of a service, so wherever there is a rank and there is an order of ranking, the preferences, automatically the highest ranked preferred will be selected into consideration or taken into consideration. Next one is the constant sum, where the people are asked to respond in a constant manner, in a cumulative manner, and out of that, highest being cumulatively got among the total points, that will be selected into a best one or a best reason or a best situation, as in the case of research, in the case of marketing, the best product, right? Next one, the Q-sort scaling, where the people are being asked to respond on a given of a large number of variables, and the people who opted for highest in all the categories like low efficiency level, moderate efficiency level, or high efficiency level, or average level, or moderate level, and high level, like that, whatever it may be. There will be a totaling of all those who responded in a similar manner, and they will be put in a queue. First of all, high efficiency will be taken into consideration. After that, moderate efficiency will be taken into consideration. After that, the low efficiency will be taken into consideration, like that, in a ascending order. In a ascending order, we will not go into that. We will go for a descending order from top to bottom. We will go first to prefer for the high level, then moderate level, and then low level. So like that, a Q level sorting scale will be put into consideration. So I have hoped that you might have learned it very carefully. I request you to go once again, and till then, stay safe and stay protected. Thank you. Thank you very much, all of you.